come to stay as we live Christmas every day. A joyful morning to one and all. Christmas is here, bringing along happiness and cheer. Hot chocolate, candy canes, and presents under the tree are all things we associate with Christmas. However, the birth of Christ shall always ring true in our hearts as we celebrate giving to others and spreading the Christmas cheer. A day without prayer is a day without blessing, and a life without prayer is a life without power. So I would like to invite Pranav G from 6B to deliver the school prayer.
Father of all mercies, I offer you my studies and other duties. Bless our institution, our teachers, and our students. May this school always be the home of truth, wisdom, faith, and excellence. Help me to build the whole community and inspire me to choose and follow truth. Kindly lead us and bless us all the way. Amen.
Thank you, Pranav. Spreading joy through the magic of song is always a key part of Christmas cheer. So now I would like to invite our dearest Aishwarya and Irene for the prayer song.
Color the world with gladness, color the world with joy, color the world with the rainbow of love, color the world with song. Let the colors of music fill the nations, reaching to the ends of the earth. Come, let us sing and make music for the
courage rather than intelligence. So I would now like to invite Alan from the thought of today.
Thought for the day. Glory to God in the highest, and on the earth peace to men of goodwill, says the Bible. When Jesus was born, angels sang this hymn. They were praising God and wishing peace to men whom God favors. It means when we follow God's ways, we will be blessed with peace. Thank you.
Thank you, Alan. That was very inspiring. Our obligation to our country never ceases, but with our lives. So I would now like to call Shiva for the pledge.
India is my country. All Indians are my brothers and sisters.
I love my country and am proud of its rich and varied heritage. I shall always strive to be worthy of it.
I shall give respect to my parents, teachers, and all elders and treat everyone with courtesy.
To my country and to my people, I pledge my devotion.
Their well-being and prosperity alone lies my happiness. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Shiva. Love came down at Christmas. Love all lovely, love divine. Love was born at Christmas. Stars and angels gave the sign. All the students of Tris have come together on this special occasion to bring us a beautiful nativity play to showcase the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Get ready to see this wondrous occasion enacted right before you. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to all men of goodwill on earth. Let us prepare to welcome the Prince of Peace amidst us.
Celebrate the birth of Jesus.
Can you tell the story of the holy birth of Jesus?
Sure, it is a historical incident which has been told and retold in more than 2,000 years.
A long time ago, in a faraway town called Nazareth, there lived a girl named Mary. She was beautiful and full of love for God. One day, an angel appeared to her. It was Angel Gabriel. The angel told Mary, "You are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was a little frightened when she heard the angel's voice. Seeing this, the angel said, "Do not be afraid, Mary. God has sent me to tell you that you are going to have a son, and he will be called Jesus, the Son of God." But Mary told that she was not married, to which Gabriel replied that the Holy Spirit will fill Mary, and she will bear the Son of God. Mary was happy and told, "May the Lord's wish be done." The angel left. Sometime later, Mary got married to Joseph, a carpenter, who lived in the same village. Emperor Augustus Caesar wanted to know how many people lived in his land, so all the emigrants were asked to go to the land where they were born. Now Joseph was from a town which was miles away from Nazareth. He and Mary set off on a long journey to Bethlehem. It was winter time and it was very cold also. Joseph was worried about Mary. He asked her to sit in a safe place and went to find a place for them to stay. When Mary and Joseph arrived at Bethlehem, things didn't look good at all. There was no room available anywhere. Finally, Joseph got a place in where there was a stable behind one of the innkeeper's home. Joseph was pleased and thanked the innkeeper for his help, saying, "May God reward you for your help and kindness." He took Mary and went to the stable. As it was a common practice for the shepherds to sleep in the open at night while taking turns to stay awake to guard their sheep from wild animals, there appeared to the shepherds an angel in the sky that announcing the birth of Jesus, the Savior of the world, lying in a manger in Bethlehem. The shepherds were very happy and overjoyed to hear this wonderful message of hope. The three kings were making their way tonight carrying gold, frankincense and myrrh to be presented to the King of Kings, seeing the star in the sky as foretold by the prophets. On the way, they inquired from Herod, the emperor, whether he knew anything about the birth of Jesus, the king, which he replied, "I haven't heard anything so far," and requested them to inform him if they find him. The three kings, after finding Jesus, left through another route on the advice of an angel. The shepherds and the angels fell on Jesus' feet, praising and worshipping him by singing and dancing. Above all, Mary will be happy if all of us give our hearts to Jesus.
Have heard on high, sweetly singing all the now sing glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled, joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies with angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem.
Merry Christmas to each one of you. May the peace and love of Christ remain with us all through our life.
Thank you, students. That was lovely. I would now like to call upon our beloved CEO, sir, for a quick Christmas message.
Good morning, everyone. What comes to our mind when we think of Christmas? Christmas star, Christmas tree, cake, Christmas cards, carols, Santa Claus, gifts, etc. In my childhood, we used to go singing carols, of course, to raise some money for our club. Also, we used to send Christmas cards to our relatives, your friends, those days. They are very rare these days. It's a festive season. In December 1986, I spent a week with my family in London. Shops and streets were decorated. Santa Clauses of different size seen walking on the streets distributing sweets. The scenario in Kerala is not very much different. We celebrate Christmas with fun and frolic. Christmas stars symbolize the stars that guided the wise men to the manger. Gifts symbolize the same brought by the wise men. Carols, the hymns sung from the heaven. Santa Claus is a legendary character originating in Western Christian culture, who is said to bring gifts on Christmas Eve to well-behaved kids. He was a 4th century Greek bishop, known as Father Christmas in Britain. We keep gifts for our kids under the Christmas tree, remembering Santa. However, the essence of Christmas is lost. We spend lavishly for feasts and get-together. There are thousands of people in our locality who do starve. Do we care for them? Can't we raise some funds for the marginalized and downtrodden? Can't we collect good clothes which we no longer use for the orphans or for the inmates in the old age home? We do have an old age home adjacent to our school. Let us collaborate and help them. Let our class teachers play a pivotal role in consolidating the collection of these articles. Christmas comes and goes. But if we can extend a helping hand, provide a meal at least for those inmates on this Christmas day, then Christmas has no meaning. We are paying only lip service then. On behalf of the chairman, Dr. S. Joy Raja, the management and the fraternity of the Rajas International School, Kurichy, Kottayam, I wish you all a Merry Christmas.
Thank you, CEO, sir. That was splendid. We will now remember that Christmas is giving, and sharing love is what we were truly set out to do. For it is in giving that we shall receive. The students have also made a lovely video on the meaning of Christmas and why we should celebrate it. I hope everyone enjoys it.
The festival of Christmas is celebrated all around the world, proclaiming the birth of Jesus Christ, the Savior of humankind, irrespective of caste, color, religion, etc. Now, let us watch an ideal Christmas celebration. We can celebrate Christmas by helping the poor and the needy, sharing and caring for others, and comforting and consoling the lonely, aged, and the abandoned.
So this is Christmas. what have you done? Another year over, a new one just begun. And so this is Christmas, I hope you have fun. The near and the dear ones, the old and the young.
Thank you everyone for your hard work. Teachers have three loves: love of learning, love of learners, and love of bringing the first two loves together. So now I'd like to invite Mini Miss to share the joy of Christmas.
Respected CEO sir, respected principal, and my dear colleagues and students. The birth of Jesus brought hope, love, and salvation for all human races. Love that transforms each one of us to be another Christ. Loving others unconditionally, caring for others, sharing our riches with the less fortunate ones in the society. To bring love where there is despair and hopelessness, and to love others just as we love ourselves. So, dear friends, let this season of Christmas help us to radiate the love of Christ so as to illumine the hearts and minds of people so that they may be able to experience the goodness of salvation which Jesus Christ has brought into the world. Wishing you all a Merry Christmas.
Thank you, Minimus. That was absolutely amazing. I would now like to invite Irene from AS Level to sing us a splendid carol to celebrate the jolly day.
Respected CEO sir, teachers, and my dear students, wish you happy Christmas and bright new year. When we think about the birth of Jesus, we come across a lot of contradictions the first thing comes to our mind is the cowshed where he was said to have been born. Not really a good place for anybody to be born. Then what about the Savior? The birth of the Savior was announced to the shepherds, not to the wise, nor to the royalty. Shepherds were regarded a little higher than nomads, and nothing more than that. Again, what was the symbol given to them? You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. Like an orphan, Jesus was born in a cowshed. He was attended by the lowliest of the people. He was not clad even in good dress. There was an air of poverty and privation. There was no celebration. He identified himself to be the poorest of the poor. I think this is the message this Christmas gives us. Open our eyes. Look around. We can see the poor, the marginalized, the oppressed. We can see babes in manger, dustbin, and on the street. Our Savior is among them. Whenever we do something for them, our Christmas becomes meaningful. May your prayers escaped from our lips won't help us. In Gitanjali, Tagore sings, Lord, here is thy footstool, and there is thy feet where live the poorest, the lowliest, and the lost. Let us follow the footprints of Jesus. Let us follow the only law he gave us. Love one another. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Our children have come together for a special Santa dance. So let us watch them put on the most magnificent of shows.
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. Oh, the fields we go.
Christmas is a time for giving. the effort of all our hardworking teachers and students this Christmas has come together, and everyone has truly learned the purpose of this joyous occasion that we call Christmas. Everyone's contributions have made sure that this Christmas will be a memorable one. Thank you all, and have a wonderful Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Let this Christmas bring you all joy,